Welcome back to another Mukbang Monday.
It's your favorite dynamic duo, B-Mars
and Shanti.
We're eating something extra special today, which is lots of things. What are we gonna? We're doing a lot right now. We're making the not so famous, but famous by our standards, cucumber salad. We've mentioned it and ate it a couple of times in past bangs.
I remember one bang in specific that we made this cucumber salad recipe that a lot of people said they wanted the recipe for. Mm-hmm. And so today we're gonna give that to you.
Break it down.
I'm also gonna show you how to make a stir fry tofu wicked easy recipe. And we are also gonna be eating some brown rice, some lettuce cups, and this is a super special video.
I bought some mother-in-law's kimchi because I went to Whole Foods. Let's talk about that later. But this white kimchi, is it called something specific or just white kimchi?
It's just called vegan white kimchi, yeah.
Me and Chantal have not tried before, so we're gonna taste test it on camera. And then I also have the radish version, mm-hmm. but it is not vegan, unfortunately.
But this is special because we rarely have mother-in-laws make an appearance on this mukbang channel.
We're very,
we love
loyal
our
to our king's kimchi.
Yeah. It's just so good.
Hashtag sponsor us, please.
Yeah, seriously.
Hit me up.
So yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing today. We got a couple things going on. First, we are gonna show you the delicious cucumber salad recipe.
Yes, I also cut up some radishes just for funsies because we had some.
Yeah.
Okay.
This recipe is actually not ours. We found it online.
Yeah, it's like the first or second Google search that comes up for Korean cucumber salad.
We'll link it down below.
Yes. First thing is first, we're going to mix the soy sauce, vinegar, and sugar. We're going to be doubling the recipe down below, or the link that we left down below. So we need 2 tablespoons of
soy sauce.
Soy sauce. I literally was like, tamari, but you can use any soy sauce.
Oh yeah, we're using tamari. I also brought over some soy sauce just in case. By the way, we both just went to the gym and showered. It is lunchtime. Usually we film dinner bangs and we're both looking like shaggy fluffy dogs.
I know. Both of us, our hairs are still wet because neither of us believe in
blow drying.
Heat products. Honestly, ever since I stopped straightening and curling my hair, it has grown so much.
Yeah.
I can't even believe it. Okay. 4 tablespoons of rice wine vinegar. I just got this one from Royals. Nothing fancy. Cairo, I swear to God.
I don't know. I saw him like creeping in from behind us.
I don't know. He used to be so content sitting between us, and lately he has been yearning for the lap. Okay.
Make him stay.
And last. Okay. You cannot. And then we're going to do 2 tablespoons of sugar.
Nice.
Use the other side. I would never think to put sugar in this.
A little bit of sweetness.
For your sour. And so now we're just gonna mix all this up. Is it rude if I just use this?
Nah, save a dish.
Spoon. So the next thing we're going to add is chili powder, and we are going to use our favorite gochujaru. Thank God we bought this
huge
bag.
I know, one of the best decisions we've ever made.
So this is a 1/2 teaspoon or more of red chili powder. One time I made this and I accidentally did a tablespoon. And it was spicy AF, but it was so good. Do you remember that?
I don't really remember that, but
it was like blood red.
Really?
Yeah.
Was it still good though? Like, was it edible?
It was really good. It says 1 teaspoon, but like, should I do 2?
Teaspoon?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Let's make it how it is, and then if we want to add more, we can.
Yeah. That's what this recipe actually says, that you should mix the other ingredients first and then do the chili powder, because you can kind of add more as you go. And the last step is obviously to add your cucumbers and green onions, which are kind of optional, but it's the option we chose. And then if you want this cucumber salad to be really fresh and crunchy, you can eat it right away. And if you want it to be a little bit more soft and really soak up the juices, wait about 10 minutes.
Yeah, we actually ended up keeping this in the fridge and it was so good even after like a day or two.
Yeah. It really soaks everything up.
It gets a little bit softer.
How should I mix this?
And it also says sesame seeds, right? Or no, sesame seeds.
The sesame seeds,
it says in the ingredients, but they're not like in the steps.
Yeah, should we just, I assume that means add them afterwards, but do you want to just add them?
Yeah.
Get them all sticky. I feel like We should have doubled it.
No, I think that's all. Because they'll, like,
shrink down.
Soften, yeah. That's good. It's probably good.
Protein, protein, protein. To the channel. We all know and love.
Protein, protein.
I'm just going to mix this in so they're really stuck on everything. Sorry, this is loud. I'll turn it down. Good editing. And there you are. How does it look, Shanti?
It looks so good. And that is it. It's so easy.
To show you the bowl. Wow.
Beautiful.
So we like to let it sit and soak up the juices. So I'm going to put her over here.
Mm-hmm. And while that soaks, I'm going to show you guys a really easy, delicious stir-fried tofu recipe. I make this a lot when I come home from the gym and I want like a quick protein meal. Oh my, this just like popped off. I don't know if you guys can see this.
Oh my gosh.
This mother-in-law's kimchi is so, what is
fermented?
The word? Bubbly?
Yeah.
It has been like overflowing.
Oh my god. It wants to be ate immediately. It's been sitting in the fridge for a good like, I mean, in the sink, you know, you like open it and let it spew. For at least like 20 minutes before I brought it over.
The juices are still flowing.
They're living their best life.
But I'm just gonna grab the skillet. So while this heats up, I guess I'll show you some of our ingredients.
That kimchi smells so strong. It's like distracting.
Yeah. Last time I've tried mother-in-law's, it's like very sour.
Yeah.
All right. So back here, I have one package of tofu. This is Trader Joe's. They sell like super high in protein tofu. It's like wicked dense and firm. So
it has more protein than like other tofus?
I think just because like look how like densely compact this is.
Oh wow.
Yeah, so I don't know like what they do differently. So we're using one package of tofu. And I'm just gonna kind of dry fry them. I'm not gonna use any oil in the pan because I'll be adding liquid in a second.
Dry fry, that's pretty good.
Dry fry. Have you ever heard that?
No, but I think you should coin the phrase.
I think it's a thing.
Oh, damn it.
Yeah.
Call it your own.
And let's just close this a minute and let that brown up a little bit. I love this skillet.
It's literally the best thing that has ever happened to
us. I know, look, it doesn't even stick.
I don't even remember what mukbang was like before this.
Right?
When I watch our first mukbangs, it makes me LOL.
I'm so awkward.
And the camera's like 1,000 feet away. Yeah. It's like across a table in a different room. We're like, welcome to a mukbang Monday.
Okay. So if you guys are new here, first of all, welcome. Make sure you subscribe to our channel by hitting that subscribe button down below. We post Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. And we cook, we chit-chat, and
eat. There we are. That's pretty much sums it up, so don't forget to hit that red subscribe button down below and turn on the notification bell so you never miss an upload.
Yeah, and if you are a returning visitor, welcome back. We love you guys. We have some of the best subscribers, I feel like.
I know.
People are so nice and
so supportive.
Yeah.
And I love how everyone is just so responsive. Like, we ask questions, we have topics.
Yeah, I love it.
And there's never a week that goes by that someone hasn't, like, responded with an interesting comment that I'm like, wow, I never thought of that, or oh, I didn't see it in this perspective, or
yeah,
I don't know, it's really cool to be able to like see what people think,
right?
Besides us,
but I was
like having friends,
we have friends, that's all I've ever wanted.
If me and Chantal aren't like, if, when she leaves to babysit on the weekends, or I go to Max's or whatever, if the other person isn't here, we're like by herself, we're like, hello. I don't know what to do this.
Yeah.
You need to come back.
Stuck into the cats.
I have nothing to do.
But you have friends. I have two friends, you and Kathy. She's leaving in a week, so it's going to be you again.
That's not true.
And I have my internet friends. But I was going to say, if you are new here, you probably don't know this, but we used to mukbang on our personal channels, mm-hmm. and we would film in our kitchen table, and the camera would be like a mile away.
But we just had no idea.
And we'd just be like sitting in our chairs, like,
yeah,
eating takeout. All right, I'm going to go ahead and add the rest of the ingredients. Actually, I'm going to let this sit a little bit more. Well, BRB. By the way, I was drinking one of these in our last mukbangs, and I forgot to mention it. Trader Joe's came out with their own brand of kombucha, and they are so good, you guys.
Is it new?
Yeah.
I haven't heard of it. Wait, I want to get a drink.
Yeah, you want to get a bev?
I need a bev. I just got a yerba. You already know. We love a good yerba mate.
You already know.
I need some energy. I got a lot of editing to do today.
I drank a yerba before I went to the gym, actually, and I felt, like, instantly crazy. Like, my brain was, like, spewing information so fast.
It's so funny. That's how
I was, like, overload.
That's how I feel every time I drink a cold brew. I'm like, literally every time. For some reason, I'm always in the car, like, drinking cold brew, and I'm like, like, I don't know, it just hits me so fast.
Like, mentally and physically.
Yeah, and then I'm like, let's do things, let's do it, let's do it.
And then it's just like a solid crash and burn. This is what I don't really like about caffeine. I was on a no caffeine kick for a while, I talked about it a little bit.
Yeah.
And I'm back on the caffeine, and like, I just feel like I should go off it again. More stable. It's really good to be like stable.
I feel like you don't drink the caffeine often, so when you do, it like really affects you.
I've been having coffee every day for a little while now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I really loved my no caffeine
kick
that I was on. All right, let's see these bad boys. All right, now that they are a little bit toasty, I'm gonna add the rest of the ingredients. I always just kind of eyeball this. Sorry, guys. I'll try to give measurements. So I'm gonna be adding in maybe like a tablespoon of soy sauce, I think. Let's see. Next, I'm adding in a teaspoon of minced garlic, or you could use one clove of garlic, but this is the lazy route. Next, I feel like this is the key. You need some sweetness to balance out the salt. So I'm adding in just a splash of maple syrup. Like, it sounds kind of weird, but
it's like putting the sugar in the cucumber.
It kind of, yeah, it's like, gives like a teriyaki-ish flavor. And I always love to add some ginger, but I'll just add a little bit because Brittany isn't a big ginger fan. But I like to just add a little squirt. Maybe like just a little pinky of ginger.
A little pink. I wish I liked ginger. It's so good for you.
And that's really it. Sometimes I add some rice vinegar. It gives it like more of a tang. And lastly, when it's done cooking, I will roll it around in sesame seeds. Actually, while this is like kind of moist, I'm going to add the sesame seeds so that they stick. Here, get on your side. Thank you. Also, this huge tub of sesame seeds is like another great purchase we made.
Yeah.
I'm gonna add in some green onions.
This smells so good.
I know, right?
I'm so glad that I like tofu. Like, I was always so scared to try it growing up because it has such a negative...
Yeah, people are like, ew, tofu.
Yeah. But really, it's just better than every day. Well, it's so quick.
It's quick. It's
so good.
It takes on whatever you, like, marinate it in. Yeah. It really doesn't have a flavor. I love the texture.
For me, you don't have to worry about it, like, making you sick. Like, I never cook meat because I'm always afraid that I didn't cook it long enough and I'm gonna, like, get sick.
So we just did a little taste test of the cukes.
That's so good. You don't want to add spice?
I like it either way.
We could add spice. I think I'm an addict. I have sriracha. I can live.
No, we can do it. Let's do a little bit, yeah.
Okay. We just did a little taste test of the cukes. And we're going to add a little bit more glass.
Goju doru. Did I put the scoop up?
God, every time I open this bag, it's like...
Yeah.
Just hits you.
Look at Cairo.
Just watching us.
Ever since we like kicked him out of Brittany's lap, he's just on the other couch, like half asleep, but like half like glaring at us.
Yeah.
It's funny. I feel like my friend Ryan, who I talk about all the time, who like, he's one of my only friends that actually watches our mukbangs. He texts me like every time we bang for some reason.
He knows.
Yeah.
Six.
But he just asked me, do you guys think you could ever do a live stream? Or do you think not enough people will watch?
I don't know. Some people have mentioned a live stream before for like a whatever Wednesday video. But I don't know if we're big enough for that, you know? No, like, not saying that having one or two people watch a live stream would still be amazing, but analytics-wise, it could really actually kind of hurt our channel. If people didn't watch it. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
If we kept it as a video and it didn't get a lot of views, because now with all the new YouTube changes, like, if you have any videos with, like, really bad views, they won't suggest your video to other people.
Yeah.
So it's definitely something we should think about, but then it's like once we live stream it, I would want to keep it live on the channel.
Mm.
And I'd be afraid that people wouldn't click on it.
We could do live stream on like a different app.
Oh yeah, we could. That's smart.
We don't have to live stream on YouTube.
I have LiveMe. I have a YouNow.
Yeah.
I never use it. I never live stream anywhere. We could live stream on Facebook.
Yeah.
We could live stream on Instagram. It's literally everywhere. Let us know.
That would be fun. We could like live eat with
people. And like they could ask us questions in real time. It could be like a Q&A. But should we just do it on Facebook? I mean, on YouTube? I don't know. Let us know if you guys think we should do a YouTube live stream. And if we do, what would be like the best time platform for everyone?
And time, yeah.
Yeah, platform and time, because we want as many people as possible. We don't know where our subscribers are. I feel like it's very mixed.
Yeah, it is.
So I don't know what would be the best for everyone.
Yeah, let us know.
Yum!
This looks great.
Here's a bow.
This is everything I've ever wanted.
This is also just like a really simple meal idea.
Mm-hmm.
I really like when our videos are just simple, because then people will more likely make them.
Okay. So first, you want to taste test the tofu.
That's the taste.
Cheers.
Mmm.
Really good.
Perfect. Literally perfect.
Now we're going to taste test the gyukes.
Gyukes.
I hope they can see them back there.
I know.
Bring them back. Oh, I got two on accident.
It's okay.
Like.
Cheers.
Mmm.
I could eat this all the time.
Mm-hmm. It's so simple, but delicious.
Okay, should we do the mother-in-laws before we...
Yeah, I was gonna start filling up my bowl.
I know. It's like just protruding out. It's like bothering me. I'm like, okay, I'll eat you.
Yeah.
Calm down.
I know.
It's so weird eating this with a fork.
I know. We need some chopsticks, don't we?
Yeah, we're gonna eat the lettuce wraps.
Yeah.
Mmm.
Mmm. I loved it a lot.
Mmm. I'm actually surprised I like this better than her spicy one. The mother-in-law's, yeah.
This isn't as sour as I remember the red one being.
Yeah, the red one, like this one right here, the radish one, is so sour. Like, it's good, but it also makes me like,
yeah,
pucker. But this is really refreshing and crisp.
I love this one.
Mmm. For me, you get the Red King's kimchi and the white mother-in-law's.
Yeah, those are my favorites.
That's the winners here. Okay, I want to make a cup.
A cup. I love, if you guys are struggling to get in greens, try the cups, because like, it's like you're eating a salad, but it's like way more fun.
Yeah. And you always get to put whatever you want in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Like, sometimes I feel like salads can be so...
boring?
Not even boring, but like, you know, you feel like you're stuck having to pick a dressing. Like, for me, I never eat salads because I don't like dressings.
Me? That's what my mom's issue is. That's her excuse for not eating enough salads.
She doesn't like dressing?
Yeah, she's like, I just can't find a good dressing.
Yeah.
But I mean, this is
a completely different way to eat salad.
Yeah. For me, I kind of like... dressing's never an issue for me because I just like the way the vegetables all taste together. Like, if you get, like... like dried cranberries or nuts on top and avocado, like it kind of all just mixes it together. You don't really need a dressing for that if you have like enough toppings. Can I have some sriracha?
Mm-hmm. Just swap it over.
Thank you.
I'm trying to figure out a way to like so that you could have more cucumber.
Oh, I forgot about the cucumber for a sec.
Sorry if that's loud, guys. I hate when I like accidentally...
I'm just gonna reach over you. Is that okay?
Do you want me to put it in the middle or no? That should be okay.
It's okay. That's okay with you. All right, so this is my cup I got going on. Tofu, rice, kimchi, gyukes, and sriracha.
I should have tofu rice one. Sorry, guys. I'm so hungry. I just went for it.
That's okay. Mmm. Wow. That's so good.
Mmm. I love the tofu.
You?
Mm-hmm. It's funny, like, every time I cook, I just assume that I have to add spice to stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So it's nice doing some stuff that isn't spicy and, like,
balancing it with the spicy
thing. Or just, like, I forget, like, not everybody likes spicy stuff, so it's probably good to show them this recipe.
Mm-hmm. My mom hates spice.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Whenever I come home, she's like, you put way too much spice in everything.
That's funny. You know how, like, the meme is, like, how people always say white people, like, only season their food with salt and pepper.
Mm-hmm.
And how they don't use any spices. Your mom is the reason for the meme.
Mm-hmm. So good. I can't talk because I'm...
stuffing?
Stuffing my face.
These kimchi's like, are so long.
Yeah. I know. I feel like Mami Tang always cuts hers. Or she rips it. Sorry. You guys miss Mami Tang as much as we do.
Yeah. I just want to know, like, are you okay?
Oh.
Where have you been?
Is you okay?
Is you happy? Because if you're happy not banging, I'm not going to force you to bang.
Yeah. I mean, she was on a roll for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she was pumping out so many bangs. Or bongs.
Bongs. But you never know.
So, since the Winter Olympics are upon us, we were thinking today we could talk a little bit more about them. We talked about them in our last...
Valentine's Day.
Was Valentine's Day?
Mm-hmm. I have to say, a lot of people don't really like the Winter Olympics. Everyone says it's boring. I keep hearing like different podcasts and stuff talk about them.
I mean, I don't think it's as exciting as the summer ones. Mm-hmm. Summer you have swimming, gymnastics. I love watching
gymnastics.
I think
it's like fast paced.
Yeah. You have like the running and like track and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
But
it's just slow.
You know what's funny? Hmm. In the last bang that we talked about the Olympics, I mentioned how like the snowboarding terrifies me. Like I can't imagine doing that. Like those tricks off the slopes and stuff. I just was watching I think it's like the first US gold was a 17-year-old snowboarder boy from, he's actually born in the same town that like Colin is from in Ohio. Isn't that cool?
Oh.
Yeah, and now he lives in Colorado though. But I watched his run and it was crazy.
Wait, he won the gold?
Yeah.
Wow.
For like the specific event.
Category?
Event, yeah. And but yeah, like there, I saw a meme. This is why I like went on YouTube and watched all these clips. That was like he overslept, lost his jacket, his parents were like shotgunning beers, and he won the gold medal that same day. The meme was like something about how like American is that.
Oh my god, that's so funny. I had no idea his backstory. Didn't Shaun White also do something crazy?
Yeah, I was seeing stuff about
Shaun White.
Yeah. But
he's been around forever, just like a legend in snowboarding. Like, must be nice.
Yeah. But I don't really know much about the skating that's going on. I need to like get caught up.
Sorry, I was going to talk about skating. So,
oh yeah,
our guy.
Fill me in.
So I'm not really sure. Let me pull up his name. I want to make sure I say it right. I don't really know all the, what did you say, events?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I just think of like ice skating, but you know, there's like duets and then there's like men and there's like women and I don't know if there's like different weight classes. I have no idea how they separate it.
Mm.
But so for the men's ice skating, I know that US got the bronze and like Canada got the gold. And it was kind of messed up because the US, his name is Adam Rippon. He had a perfect routine.
Oh, this is what Matt's telling us.
Yeah. Literally, I watched it. He nailed it, but ended up getting bronze because the guy who won gold attempted a harder routine, and even though he fell twice, they give more points for, like, attempting harder things.
Well, it's the level of difficulty, right?
Yeah. But I think it's kind of messed up. You shouldn't be trying things if you aren't going to land, just for, like, point sake.
I don't know. I can see both sides, honestly.
It shouldn't be cleanliness?
Well, I don't think you can go in doing something wicked easy that everybody can do and win.
Yeah. Know? Well, it should be like, you know, obviously like a triple axel is more than a double axel, but if you fall out of your triple axel, you shouldn't have done it. You know?
I feel like that's how it is in dance.
Like, yeah.
People are always like, I'd rather a clean double than a
sloppy falling out of a triple.
Yeah.
Yeah. So maybe like, that's why I think that way.
Mm-hmm. But
I'd rather be clean and on it, like, because then if I was an ice skater and I was in the Olympics, I would just be trying to do the hardest crap I could.
And just like falling.
And just falling. I'd just be, because I'm not afraid to fall. I fall all the time. I'm always hurt. So it's like, taking a couple bruises for a gold medal doesn't sound so bad. You know what I mean?
I don't want to see it. I haven't seen that at all.
Mm. Yep.
I saw another thing that was Mirai Nagasu makes figure skater history landing a triple axel.
Wow.
But I'm confused by that.
First American?
First American?
Really?
Oh,
so other people have done it before?
Yeah.
Okay, because I was like, I've definitely seen triple axels before.
Yeah.
But.
Well, go for her. You know what else I love about the ice skating this year? That same guy, Rippon.
Mm-hmm.
He's the first openly gay male in the Olympics.
First of like this year or like ever?
I think ever.
Just of ice skating?
I think in the Olympics. I don't. want to like misquote. Yeah, I think he was like the first openly gay like Olympian, basically, because even like obviously there has been other gay people, but you don't really like, talk about it.
Mm.
And he's super about open. It. And I just love that we're like becoming more accepting and whatever. And yes, every time he like wins or does something well, like apparently he makes like remarks about our vice president and stuff like that. It's just, it's nice to like, I don't know, have that represented in the Olympics, something that's like so widely watched like around the world.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if you don't follow him on Twitter,
do you?
You probably should. I started to because he has some fire tweets. Max showed me this. Let me just read you this. I was recently asked in an interview what it's like to be a gay athlete in sports. I said it's exactly like being a straight athlete. Lots of hard work, but usually done with better brows.
Oh, that's funny.
He's so good. I am obsessed with him. This is my other favorite one. To all those who tweeted at me saying that they hope I fail, I have failed many times, many times.
People say that
in my
to
life.
Him?
I know. But more importantly, I've learned from every setback, proudly own up to my mistakes, grown from disappointments, and now I'm a glamazon bitch ready for the runway.
Oh god, I love him.
He's so in your face. I just love it. Now I'm a glamazon. It's everything I've ever wanted someone to say.
I want
more.
To be his friend.
I know. He seems so fun. That's it for the Olympics. Again,
we're gonna stay updated and talk about it more in the next bang.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we don't have cable, so it's a little hard for us.
We gotta wait for the YouTube trend.
We got to wait to see what's coming out on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
But I thought another thing that just happened is, a lot of you guys have been talking about this in the comments. The four finale was, I think, last week. And if you guys didn't know, I was in the audience at the four at one day. And a lot of people were saying that they saw me, and I am very embarrassed.
No, don't be embarrassed.
No, I am.
Did you get into the four because you were in the audience?
That's what I was going to say. Mm-hmm. So I hadn't really watched the four before. But then once I saw all the contestants, I kind of like got into it.
You watched one of the early like episodes, didn't you?
I was on one of the early, like maybe like episode 3, I think. Mm. I don't really know what number it was. But yeah, then I started kind of watching it, just like YouTube clips, to try and keep up with the people that were on the show.
See who wins.
Yeah, and I don't know how many people actually watch this, but I didn't realize that it was so popular until
I had no idea. I thought when I saw the billboards for the four, I honestly was like, oh cool, another voice in / American Idol, like everyone's gonna hate this because they're gonna think it's copying
right
these shows. But I didn't actually watch the show, and it's set up differently than
it's very different. Yeah, so basically there's four chairs, and I heard that the people auditioning coming on every week, like they just show up, like it's not like really planned. They just like come fly in and then they try to take over one of their seats.
That's crazy.
I don't know if that's like fake news or not, but while we were, I went with my friend Kathy, who I talk about all the time because she's my only friend, but we were so, I don't know about if appalled is the right word. We were shook at such big personalities that P. Diddy and Khaled had. They were characters. Like they cut out a lot. I don't know if I should really say this, but on set, they were just like going off for like 30 minutes, and but we were all just like in the audience, like, please hurry it up.
Please stop.
Yeah. But anyways, now I want to talk about the winner.
Wait.
Sorry, go ahead.
I wonder if that's them being characters, or like, what if that's what it's like to hang out with P. Diddy?
No, that's definitely absolutely what they're like. They were just so like extra, like, I don't know.
But
like,
imagine.
Very funny and like great for TV, but they were just like literally so funny and like,
I could barely watch a clip of the show because I thought DJ Khaled talked too much.
Really?
Just let alone like
being a
watch
person.
The whole show, yeah.
Yeah. It was fun. But anyways, everybody thought that Javaya was gonna win, or at least I did. That she's definitely the most talked about on social media now.
And fan favorite.
Fan favorite, yes, that's the word. But yeah,
I thought she was gonna win too. She's literally everywhere.
And they would always talk about how they loved her so much. The judges would.
I just don't get, so you were telling me that someone swooped in like at the end and won it.
Yeah, Evie, who is literally amazing, like probably the best singer, like deserved to win.
Mm.
But what's
That's
weird
good.
About how the four set up is they don't follow, it's not like they audition and they follow the same group of people throughout the show.
Yeah.
Like it's so like on off. She came in towards the end and ended up winning, but it's kind of like you don't really get to like grow with that person, you know, like you like barely know her and then she won.
So you don't feel like
connected. Right. So yeah, but Evie won and she was amazing.
What did you win?
She is claimed iHeartRadio's top upcoming artist. She gets like a record deal and
some other. That's a pretty good winning.
Yeah,
just right? Just a record deal. You're signed.
She was amazing though. Javaya had like a cool look and was very unique definitely, but I was very confused why they all thought she was so good. No offense. Like, I don't know if I should say that, but what do you think, Kathy?
Her vocals were not as good, but she was like...
so unique.
Trendy.
Yeah, exactly.
I feel like people, especially nowadays with social media and everyone just being like in the palm of your hand, like... I feel like from the judge's point of view, they're probably like, oh, if you look cool, you have a huge advantage like, compared to anybody else because people are going to want to look at you and then they're going to want to listen to you.
Well, and the point of the show, they were very like adamant about this. Like the voice is all about the singing. Like they're trying to find the perfect voice. Mm-hmm. And the four was more about the whole superstar as a package.
They so were, like making sure that people knew it wasn't the voice.
Yeah. So there were a couple of people come on. They had an amazing voice, but they were like, this isn't the voice, like this is the four, you need to have the whole superstar package.
So like if you're not like good looking enough or...
I guess so, yeah, isn't that kind of shady?
It's like, how are you supposed to take that? They're like, you have an amazing voice, but you're not the package.
Right.
It's like, isn't singing about your voice?
Yeah.
That would be so heartbreaking.
But I think that's why they love Javaya, because I feel like her voice wasn't on point, but she looked so cool. And also, can we talk about those dreadlocks?
Cultural appropriation.
Let us know if you guys watched the four. I would love to know what you thought about the winner, if you guys were fans of Javaya.
I didn't watch it at all.
It was a good show. It was just entertaining, especially Diddy and Khaled were just the most. And I never realized Meghan Trainor was so sweet too. I liked her after the show.
It's funny that like you got to watch the four and got into the four because you were there, but normally you would have never gotten into it because you don't have TV.
Yeah.
Do you ever like wish that we had TV, or are you glad that we don't?
No, I'm so glad that we don't. I feel like TV is a huge distraction.
Yeah.
The only show that I would really watch is HGTV.
Ah, yes. But you can get that on Netflix, can't you? Or you can get some.
Only some, yeah. And when, like, something important is going on, it'd be nice to watch, but...
You just have to, like, search for, like, news outlets, and that's why I like watching Philip DeFranco so much, because it's like, I get... news without like watching news all day long.
That's true, but it's kind of nice to see it for yourself and form your own opinions. I feel like everybody I watch on YouTube already has an opinion and they're forcing what they think on you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's what Philip DeFranco's whole thing is. He's like, just the facts.
Really?
Yeah, but just I'm the sure, facts, but like... But once in a while, he'll be like, this is my opinion.
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. Which is nice, at least he's saying it, where I feel like a lot of other news outlets are just like, no, this is what's right. It's like, that's an opinion. It's nice to like be like, this is my opinion. Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
That's what everyone should do.
Are you? You wanna wrap it up?
No, I'm gonna eat this last one. I don't know, sometimes so delicious. I wish we had TV when it comes to like news or like the Olympics or like any award show. Like I feel like we just had 300 award shows and like we didn't watch them at all.
Yeah, I do love watching the award shows, only for the dancing.
Yeah.
I like to see how many people I recognize in the
But I think dancing. Overall it's really good that we don't have TV.
Absolutely. I don't even really like watching Netflix. I just feel like it's like kind of draining your mind and also like you're just not productive when you're watching TV for hours, you know?
Mm. I feel like you have to, what I like to do is pick one show
and watch like, an episode.
Watch an episode like a night or every other night or yeah, like in control of your TV.
I mean, I do like when we watch like Stranger Things or like,
Well, these are like amazing TV shows.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm so glad that we're not living in the time with like reality TV still being like the biggest thing. I guess there's still like The Bachelor, Bachelorette, but when we were growing up, it was all about The Jersey Shore and like that type of crazy.
Yeah, reality. You know what else I would actually watch if we had cable? Mm. Dance Moms is my guilty pleasure. I love Dance Moms. I could sit and watch Dance Moms for hours.
That's so funny.
Sorry, not sorry.
I don't know what happened.
Yeah, I feel like my siblings growing up also were such TV junkies. Like, they would sit and watch TV for, like, hours. But now, what's taking the place of TV, I feel like kids growing up just watch YouTube for hours, just on their iPads, watching video after video. So it's kind of the same thing, but in a different
light, like, context.
Yeah.
I know, what's worse? Like, they're both the same to me.
Yeah. It's kind of mindless activity. This one is going to be a long one.
Sorry about that. Sorry, not sorry about that.
Unless some of you like the long bangs.
I know.
You like them short and sweet.
I feel like sometimes we'll upload like a 40-minute bang and people are like, yay, love the length of this. And I'm like, really? I'm so touched.
Yeah.
Like, you want to watch me for 40 whole minutes? Like, we usually try to keep them around 30, like 25, 30.
Mm-hmm.
Just because we don't want you to click away.
Yeah, because I know personally when I watch, like, when I would watch Mommy Tangs, like 45-minute ones, I would like kind of scroll through.
Yeah.
And like click along.
It gets a little long.
Yeah. If you guys like this healthy recipe bang, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up.
Let us know. We asked for a couple of things in the comments.
Olympics. The four. What you thought about the winner and Javaya.
What you thought about cultural appropriation.
Yeah.
I think there was something else, but I can't remember. Hopefully you remember because you just watched this.
Those are the two main things we talked about.
Yeah.
But yeah, we love you guys very much and we'll see you next time.
Mukbang Monday out.